Thank you. That concludes the debate on people's right to choose, respecting Scotland's democratic mandate. It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call Neil Bibby.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what its urgent response is to the reported announcement regarding the closure of the Amazon Gourock site.
I call Minister Ivan McKee.
We are very disappointed to learn of the announcement made today by Amazon to consult on closing its distribution centre in Gourock, and I know this will be a very difficult time for the workforce, their families and the local areas. Scottish Enterprise spoke with the company today to better understand the situation and the issues involved, and I will be meeting with Amazon tomorrow to further discuss and understand better the decision they've made and its impact on the facility at Gourock.
Neil Bibby.
I thank the Minister for that answer and I welcome that he's to meet Amazon tomorrow. The news today that Amazon is to end its 19-year association with Gourock, costing over 300 jobs, is a hammer blow for Inverclyde and for the west of Scotland. Those workers were the unsung heroes of the pandemic. Those employees now face losing their jobs only a few weeks after making sure the rest of us got our Christmas presents. The Scottish Government is well aware of the challenges faced in Inverclyde. This is a community which has lost major employers in the past. The consequence has been economic decline, deprivation and depopulation. Can I ask the Minister, therefore, what new steps the Scottish Government will take in response to this announcement? And how will the Scottish Government support Inverclyde Council's socio-economic task force, which the Minister is a member of, to minimise the impact of this decision and to attract other new jobs to Inverclyde?
Minister.
We will continue to work with everybody wherever we can to support further investment into Inverclyde, indeed across the whole of Scotland. The member is right to identify that I'm a member of the Inverclyde Task Force and I attend that group, and they are very keen to continue to contribute to work together with others that have the interests of Inverclyde at heart to attract as much investment as we can. You'll be aware of the work that we're doing through the Clyde Mission to support that activity in the area, work through this Glasgow City Region deal, and also the investments we have managed to attract to Inverclyde over the years and will continue to do so. For example, the Diodes investment that I was very proud to be involved in landing that deal when it came to Inverclyde.
Neil Bibby.
I thank the Minister for that answer and his commitment to continue working with Inverclyde Council. I hope we can leave no stone unturned. We have debated in the past taxpayer support for Amazon. This company has been a welcome source of jobs for Inverclyde and other communities, but at some cost. There are real concerns about their employment practices, the impact they've had on our high streets, and about their tax bill being a fraction of their profits. In light of today's news, can the Minister commit to publishing in full the extent of taxpayers' support for this company and detail the full commercial relationships the Government has had with Amazon for any provision of service to the public sector? Will he also tell us how the Scottish Government intend to engage with Amazon going forward? And finally, would he agree that at some point the state maybe needs to treat Amazon with the same respect it treats the people of Inverclyde and Scotland?
Minister.
I can let the member know that a total of £2,137,000 of financial support has been provided to Amazon and Gourock. That the last support that was given to the facility in Gourock was in 2011, and that support stretched over the period 2005. Through to 2011. With regards to Fair Work, the member knows that we take that very, very seriously. It's a central tenet of our national strategy for economic transformation. It's something I personally am very keen to support across all the sectors that I work with. It's something that the Minister for Higher Education, Further Education, Youth Employment and Training met with Amazon in September 2021 and made the points and stressed in his previous role as Minister for Business, Fair Work and Skills the importance of fair work issues, and in my most recent meeting with Amazon to look for how they can continue to invest across a whole range of activities in Scotland, it was very clear with them that the centrality of fair work to our approach to economic development in Scotland was absolutely critical. So we leave no stone unturned to do what we can to support the people of Inverclyde and the people that work in Amazon Gourock at this time. And we continue, as always, to look for further inward investment and to continue to stress the absolute critical importance of fair work practices.
Kenneth Gibson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I speak in place of my Inverclyde colleague, Stuart McMillan, whose mother sadly passed away this morning. Nevertheless, his staff and Ronnie Cowan MP met with Amazon management this afternoon, and some indeed of the 300-strong workforce are my own constituents. Amazon today claimed that the Gourock facility is one of their older sites and questioned its suitability and viability. These concerns have never been raised directly with the local MSP or MP on past site visits. I'm pleased that the Minister will meet the company tomorrow. Can he advise whether he will facilitate talks between the landlord of the site and Amazon to see what improvements or investments can be made at the site to prevent closure and ensure the Gourock site will continue to be a part of Amazon's future business plans?
Minister.
I thank the member for that question, for raising that issue. As indicated, we'll leave no stone unturned to understand what is possible to be able to save the facility at Gourock. And if the member or Stuart McMillan has information that would be helpful in that regard, or any other member indeed does, be very keen to receive that before my meeting with Amazon tomorrow morning, or even following on from that. If there are opportunities where further investment can be made to get the site to a position where it is an Amazon view contributing to their operational footprint, then be very keen to explore those to any level of detail required.
Jamie Green.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Can I first of all convey my condolences to Stuart McMillan today? As a Greenock resident and someone who has been to the Amazon site, I know how much of a blow today's news will come to them, their families and the entire community. Inverclyde is resilient and will survive any economic challenges it faces, but this is such a major local employer, it will surely have a devastating impact. Can I ask the Minister if he might give serious consideration to the setup of an immediate bespoke multi-agency task force, which will bring together Amazon, the local authority, governments and other public bodies, agencies and political parties, to sit around the table and see what can be done in the immediate to support the people of Inverclyde. There is precedent for this, as he knows, with Texas Instruments, and I think it would be a very positive way to get everyone in the room together.
Minister.
Well, the member will be aware that we already have the Inverclyde Task Force in operation. That's a fabulous initiative that was started locally and invites out to myself and others to be part of that group, and I'm delighted to be able to work with them. I think that forum, which we'll be meeting again very shortly in the next few weeks, is probably the best place where we can have that discussion about what can be done, and if that group decides that there's a need for a subset of that group to have detailed discussions on this, and I'd be happy to be part of that. But I'd rather work that through the task force that's already in place rather than set up a separate group at this stage. I think it's the most effective way to use the mechanisms that are already there to take that forward. And remember, of course, we'll be aware as well, of course, that Scottish Enterprise and the PACE initiative are already working, have engaged with the business to see what support can be offered to employees should the business decide, following consultation, to close the facility.
Paul O'Kane.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer, and I associate myself with the comments of my regional colleague Neil Bibby in this urgent question. The impact of the closure of Amazon on the local economy in Inverclyde cannot be underestimated, and it is a huge concern to local people. And I think, as we've already heard, this issue does raise broader concerns about how public money is used, and indeed Amazon failing in its moral obligations to provide safe, stable and well-remunerated employment to the people of Inverclyde. Given I accept what the Minister says about leaving no stone unturned in order to try and protect a future for the site. However, it is clear that Amazon are suggesting that people will be redeployed. That doesn't seem likely. So what discussions has he had with West College Scotland, Skill Development Scotland and others about retraining and reskilling people in Inverclyde to have well-paid and secure jobs?
Minister.
Well, as I've said, the support and financial support from Scottish Government that went into the Amazon Gourock site was over the period 2005 through to 2011, and that was the last support that was made to that site. As I said, I'm very happy to engage with anyone who can come forward with solutions or where we can work together to facilitate support for the site to secure the future of it. And with regards to skills training, my colleague, Minister for Skills, of course, is engaged on an ongoing basis in programmes across the country to make sure that we upskill people in Inverclyde and elsewhere to take advantage of the many opportunities that are being created in Scotland, in all parts of Scotland, across a whole range of sectors. And as part of the discussions around this particular facility, I would be quite happy to engage with the local college and others as required.
And Ross Greer.
Thank you. Amazon are a monumentally profitable company. Their founder, Jeff Bezos, is the definition of corporate greed. They're also infamous for their hostility towards their own workers when they try to organise through trade unions. So can I ask the Minister if he'll engage with the unions such as the GMB, for whom a number of the workers at the Gourock site hold membership?
Minister.
I'm very happy to engage with GMB and include them in discussions around how we look for ways to find a secure future for the Amazon Gourock site. And again, just reiterate, our messaging to Amazon has been relentless and clear that we support the Fair Work agenda. It's absolutely central to our economic policies as a government, and we always impress upon them the importance of that and raise any issues that are raised with us in that regard. We are not treating workers fairly across any of their sites to make sure they understand how important these issues are to the Scottish Government.